scattered about, but nothing here. The sun is shining. What I would like to share this afternoon is what I think about the earthquakes in California. I feel that this earthquake swarm that's been occurring there, with the latest one being a 7.1 last night, is being caused by magma movement under the ground, some distance down, probably at the depth where these earthquakes are occurring. Does this mean an imminent volcanic eruption? Well, somebody just lost some stuff, and I have to take quick evasive action here. Like a wheelbarrow in a chair. Situations like that that I just encountered, yeah, pretty much you have to hope for the best. No damage comes to your vehicle. Everything is okay. Getting back to what I was talking about. Wheelbarrow momentarily right smack in front of me there, and it's second there. Thank you. Yeah, what I'm thinking in California is these earthquakes, but it's natural movement under the ground is causing this activity. There's just so many earthquakes occurring. There's hundreds of earthquakes a day that have been occurring in this one area around Ridgecrest, California, which is in the Mojave Desert. Ridgecrest is a town of about 20,000 inhabitants. That's the only population around there, however. It's sparsely populated once you're outside of the town. It's all desert. So where is this magma going to go? Well, that's a good question. Is it really going to cause an eruption somewhere, or is it just movement of the ground that's going to subside eventually? It's really hard to say at this point. They should be on alert, though. If these earthquakes continue. It could lead to a potential eruption in the future. Either a fissure may open up in that region, or this lava could flow up to Mammoth Lakes, which is not too far from there. It could be heading in that direction. It could be heading up toward Shasta, it could be heading up toward Mount Lassen. 95 for Hillrose. The reason why I say about the earthquakes in California that a fissure can open up is in the desert is because it has happened before. Anybody who has driven along I-40 through the Mojave Desert near the town of Ludlow, anyone who's observant will notice that there are some lava flows that are not too old that are covering parts of that valley, coming from a volcanic cone. So what likely happened with that was within the past 1,000 years, it appears, a fissure opened up, a cone, volcanic cone formed, and it spewed out lots of magma during that eruption. It covered quite a bit of that valley with lava. So I'm kind of thinking this latest earthquake swarm happening in Ridgecrest, that there could be some magma coming up toward the surface causing these quakes. Like what happened to Kilauea. Kilauea also in Hawaii had swarms during that eruption in 2018. They had swarms and swarms and swarms of earthquakes due to the movement of all that magma. So that's kind of what I suspect it could be happening in California. It's a similar pattern of earthquakes. So it does seem that there is some magma under the ground that's in motion. Will it come to the surface? I think it's still a ways down. It may not come to the surface around Ridgecrest, California. It may come up in the form of an eruption near Mammoth Lakes, that volcano. It could. Hard to say where the magma is going to go at this point, but it could go up to Mount Shasta. There's lots of dormant volcanic activity around there, up by I don't remember the name of that other lake up there. Where there's lots of evidence of volcanic activity around there. Got Mammoth Lakes and you got Mono Lake. Mono Lake as well, there is evidence that that's volcanic. Mammoth Lakes, there is possibilities that could erupt if that magma gets up that way. Who knows? We'll see. Hopefully not, for the sake of that area. Thank you. So my plan for today is to continue into Nebraska on I-76, where I will pick up I-80 once I get into Nebraska, and then take that east. Probably end up somewhere around Grand Island, Nebraska. Tomorrow I will head through Iowa, perhaps on into Illinois for what looks like to be a Monday delivery. Exit 102, Reno. Thank you. 6 at 115, Colorado 63, Atwood, Sterling.
Thank you.
46 more miles to North Platte, Nebraska, 9 more miles to Sterling, Colorado. 69, I think, to Julesburg. That's going to be it for this video.